It matters to me personally because when I was a teenager, I used to watch the South Bank show on TV on Sunday nights, and it was like this oasis of culture, and it was like the only rounded hit of culture that, you know, that I got weekly as somebody growing up who wanted to be a writer. And the fact that it's still going and now to have had a South Bank show made about me, it's very meaningful for me personally.
Of course, Happy Valley is a show that's meant so much to so many people. What are you most proud of when you look back, particularly at the second season now, with a little bit of distance?
I'm pleased it did so well. I'm pleased it got... I'm pleased our hard work was rewarded with the audience clearly engaging with it, because we did work hard. The cast and the crew worked extraordinarily hard. It was quite a tough shoot in many ways. We were shooting in some really bad weather at times, but we kept going, and it was delightful that it received the attention it got, because we worked so hard to get it right.
Of course, fans are desperate to know if there's going to be a third season. Do you feel that you still have more to tell with these characters, more to tell with that story?
I always felt that Happy Valley was going to be a trilogy, and so I'm hoping there will be more, yes.
And in terms of that process, where are you in taking us to that conclusion?
I haven't even started. I've been working on another project, a huge epic 8-parter about Anne Lister, the lesbian diarist who owned Shibden Hall in Halifax, and I'm over halfway writing the scripts for that, and it's quite a I think it's probably the hardest thing I've ever written, and I'm going to start filming that next year, and I'm going to be directing that too. So Happy Valley will come after that. She was an extraordinary human being, and she really should be celebrated, not just because she was a gay woman doing things that gay women... She was very out in the way that gay people couldn't be then or weren't. But there's so much more to her than that that's ever been said. She was an extraordinary polymath. She was incredibly gifted and intelligent and talented. And I think she's a real British character, eccentric, super talented woman who should be more celebrated. And I hope that's what we're going to do with the show.